Michael Murphy, Alderman, City of Milwaukee. Today's Friday, April 12th, a little after 9. If we could just do a roll call, please.
Member Butkiewicz?
Here.
Member Shulgren?
Here.
Member Bhattacharya?
Here.
Member Van?
Here.
Member Cervera is excused. Member Westrich?
Here.
Member Peterson is excused. Member Rainey hopefully would join us. Member Leibo?
Here.
Member Matthew would join us later. Vice Chair Lappin?
Present.
Mr. Chair?
Here. We have a quorum present. I want to first begin introducing our new member to the
Thank you.
Thank you very much for being here. Paul Mazzina.
Chairman, Alderman Murphy, and task force members. I appreciate this opportunity to talk with you, and I would like to start by asking you to revisit some of the assumptions that underlie the direction that you've chosen to pursue. And I would start with the assumption that you make, and we often hear it, is that addiction is a disease. And I would ask you to consider that there is another perspective in the medical community that says addiction is a behavior. And by calling it a disease, we've channeled the conversation down a certain path where if addiction is a disease, well, then it almost seems legitimate that government should have a criminal sanction for those who are promulgating substances that produce a disease. And I would also ask you to consider the definitions of substance use disorder promulgated by the American Psychiatric Association via their DSM, their Diagnostics and Statistics Manual. Those definitions have found their ways into law, and so that has led to the criminalization of anyone who dares to self-medicate with a substance that has been arbitrarily criminalized. So we're telling the people, the citizens of the whole country, that you are not responsible for the decisions you make to put in your body. We are, the state are. And from as soon as you're young enough to understand, we will tell you and inform you that if your behavior is not right, we have a substance for you, whether it's attention deficit disorder or obsessive compulsive, or as an adult, whether you have depression or trouble sleeping or whatever it may be, the state will tell you what you can use to medicate, and the state will criminalize you if you choose to medicate yourself with something that they don't want you to use. And so this criminalization has led to some serious problems which are not being addressed by the task force. These are results of the direction that you have chosen to take. And those results are three MPD officers died in the last 10 months, all drug war related. Officer Michalski was involved with a search warrant for drugs and guns. Officer Irvine died in a car chasing someone that was selling drugs. And Officer Rittner was killed by a man who sold $60 worth of cannabis. $60 worth of cannabis. According to the Milwaukee Homicide Review Commission, from 2014 to 2016, an average of 18 drug-related homicides have occurred in the city. An average of about 55 non-fatal shootings that were drug-related have occurred in the city. This is causing trauma. And for this task force to continue to go down a path where you do not take into consideration the criminalization of the use of substances, you're ignoring this. Is 18 homicides a year okay? Is that a metric that is indicative of success? And we also noticed that, according to Brian Peterson's numbers, the improvements that you're making in the deaths by heroin and opioids are being supplanted by increased deaths in methamphetamine and cocaine. And I heard Officer John Scrignoli from the High Intensity Drug Trafficking Area speaking to the Public Safety Committee meeting last week, and he said the same thing. He said, you know, these drugs are everywhere. And so what I'm getting at is that from a long-term strategy, and it may take more than one generation, we need to start teaching our young people that they are responsible for what they put in their bodies. The buck stops with you. and we teach people honest truth about substances. The world is full of dangerous substances. You cannot legislate your way out of that. You cannot take, people have an inherent inalienable right to be the masters of their own bodies. Yet the state is asserting, no, we know better. We know better, and if you don't follow our addictions, our laws, we will criminalize you and put you in a cage. And if you dare to sell $60 worth of cannabis, we may knock your door down with a battering ram. And so this policy, I'm asking you to consider going to your legislative liaison offices at city and county level. And just like the Fair Deal, just like the Medicaid, speak out for changes in the policy, because I know the police and everyone will say our hands are tied. The law is the law. The city takes our tax dollars, funds the police. They enforce the laws. The county has the court systems and all the machinations there. So you're all saying, wow, our hands are tied. But when it comes to Fair Deal or Medicaid, you don't hesitate to go to the legislature and say, there's a fundamental problem here. And I'm asking you to consider the unfunded mandate of the federal government to enforce the Controlled Substances Act. The Controlled Substances Act was passed by Nixon as an attack on minorities and anti-war people. People forget the history. How did we get here? Where did we get? When did we ever give up our right to be the masters of our own bodies and give that to the government? It's an inalienable right. You cannot be given to the government. Yet the government persists in taking this right. And the result has been a war on drugs. Am I, you're shaking your head, Alderman. Am I done?
You're a little bit beyond 3 minutes, but we want to wrap it up. Go ahead.
I sincerely appreciate your time. I'll sum it up. I don't mean to be perceived as being critical of what you all have accomplished. Thank you. Thank you for everything you've done. I'm simply saying, can we have an also and strategy? Can we do whatever, all the stuff you're doing and look at the criminalization, the laws, the policy, and at the city and county level, go to your legislative liaison offices and say, we need to change the laws here. You're putting us in an untenable position. So thank you for your time. And again, thank you for everything you're doing. I really appreciate the opportunity to speak with you.
Thank you, Paul, for coming.
Thank you.
Next is Kristen Grimmer.